Welcome back to Astronaut. Today we're talking about how stars reveal their true colors. I feel like an astronaut in what you know about rolling down in the deep. Okay, so first off, color is a bit of a game of perception. A star's color is based on its temperature. As revealed from Wien's displacement law, a star's temperature dictates its peak wavelength. When this peak wavelength falls in the visible regime of the electromagnetic spectrum, the wavelength corresponds to a color that can be used to describe the star. Hotter stars peak at shorter, bluer wavelengths, while colder stars peak at longer, redder wavelengths. Medium temperature stars, and when I say medium, I'm talking 6,000 Kelvin, like the sun, peak in the green part of the visible spectrum. But we never see green stars when we look at the sky, otherwise the sun would be green. Why is that? Even though the star may peak at a wavelength that makes it intrinsically green, our eyes care more about cones and rods than Wien's displacement law. In other words, our eyes are made up of blue, green, and red cones, and every color we see is a combination of these cones. But stars that peak in the green part of the visible regime will also activate the red and blue cones in our eyes. So instead of seeing a green star, we see a blend of green, blue, and red. Our eyes perceive the mixture of many colors as white, so the stars that peak in green, like the sun, appear to us as white. The hottest stars peak in the ultraviolet regime. The tail of the black body curve for these stars falls into the indigo part of the visible regime, but our eyes detect blue much more strongly than purple, so these stars appear blue to us. But let's backtrack to how we detect a star's color in the first place. When we observe a star, we view it at a particular wavelength. These viewing lenses are called filters, and the main ones in astronomy are U, B, V, R, I. U, ultraviolet, B, blue, V, verde, the Spanish word for green, R, red, and I, infrared. When we talk about the color of a star, we usually refer to how the star appears in one filter compared to another filter. That is to say, we talk about the difference between two filters. The star Vega has a B minus V value of 0.0. Because of this, Vega is often used as a baseline for magnitude comparisons. If you remember from our video on absolute and apparent magnitude, or have learned about magnitudes before, you'll note that brighter, hotter stars have lower magnitudes. Because the color index is based on the same scaling system, the values we get by taking the difference of a lower frequency filter from a higher frequency filter, i.e. B minus V, work the same way. Negative B minus V values indicate stars that are hotter than Vega, while positive B minus V values denote stars that are cooler than Vega. The star Rigel has a B magnitude of 0.1 and a V magnitude of 0.13. We can analyze Rigel's color by taking the difference of these two filters. The B minus V value is negative 0.03. Because this value is negative, we can say Rigel is hotter than the star Vega. B minus V is the most commonly used color index, partially because it's a good indicator of temperature, and partially because sensors have been historically constructed to be more sensitive to blue light. But you can choose to describe a star's color through any set of filters. The key is making sure you document your methodology well to ensure it is easily interpretable. That's all for today. Thanks for watching, and as always, ponder, wander, and go right in the stars. I feel like an astronaut.